Hello dear students, welcome in physics class. Today myself Shifali from BBM International School going to start a topic of physics, that is measurement. Why measurement is required in our life? So in this video we will discuss about the concept of measurement. Here is a conversation between a teacher and a student. In this conversation, the student telling the teacher that yesterday night he feels that she become too much longer, but in the morning when she tell to her parents, then nobody believe. So she want to describe each and everyone that she become longer, but she have no perfect units to describe it. So how will she describe? So the teacher gave an idea to the student that use the standard units for the measurement. But the student don't know about the standard units of the measurement. So let's see how she will tell about the height that she become too longer. After discussion with the teacher, she is using different methods for the measurement. Let's see. Measurements. Here are two students that are seated in a classroom and they are fighting with each other to share their table. They want equal part of the table. But it's possible only then if they know proper dividation by measuring the units. So let's check how they will divide the table. To divide the table, they need of measurements, standard units of length. So let's check the student is measure the length of the table by using different methods. He is measuring the length of the table with variable methods that will change time to time. Once he already divides the table in two equal halves. Now 10 to 15 days later, they again start fighting, and now the student again measuring the length and divide the table into two equal parts. Now he is using one other instrument to measure the length of the table, but it was not possible that it is same as that of previous one. It's going to change. So he was confused. Now how he will measure the length of the table? So they get an proper idea or proper instrument, that is scale. So scale will always remains the same units and same terms. So the student got the idea that scale is a perfect instrument to measure the length of the object. The student gave the answer to teacher. And the teacher also tell the student that yes, scale is a perfect method to measure the length of the object. It will not vary with person to person and also by place to place. Now he is thinking that I want to measure my length, but the scale is very short. So how will I measure my length? Let's check now how will she measure her length. Now there is one student that is going to measure the length of the classroom by using foot. Is it possible that every student can measure the length by his or her foot and it will same? No, because sometimes one student foot is too short and the other one student foot is too long, so the distance will vary. So it's not a correct method to measure the length of the object or a classroom. So again, this is a scale. Scale is a correct method or a fixed method to measure the length of the classroom rather than of a foot length, because scale length will always remain same. So she got an idea about the measuring tape, that just like that of scale, measuring tape is also remain same. So she can use the measuring tape to measure her height. And also, after few days, if the height will increase, then at the measuring tape also the height will show increased. So this idea she discussed with her teacher. She is discussing with her teacher about to measure the length by using measuring tape, because it is also same just like that of a scale. As all over the world, the measuring tape units also remain same. So let's check how she will measure the next one object. So here again she is going to use the improper units rather than foot also, as well as finger width also. Sometimes some person's finger are too thick and some person's fingers are too thin, so it affects it and the length will change. Inches, foot, these all are not a proper measurements to measure the length of any object or measure the length of a classroom. Now here is SI system, standard international system. This is what? This is an exact method that always remains same units all over the world. Here is meter, that tells about the SI unit of to measure the length is meter. 1 meter, 100 centimeter all over the world. You can't change it. 1 centimeter always equal to 10 millimeter. 1 kilometer, 1 kilometer always equal to 1000 meter. At the whole world. So she got an idea that SI system is the best system to measure the different units of the length. So in this way she learned about the concept to measure the length of a object, or you can say to measure the length of a classroom. So hope the topic is clear to you. Stay home, stay safe.